fucking pack off of the porch or break a pound down. Get the scrap if it happen to blow, it makes a round sounds. Pussycat on my lap, push it back and go to town down. Putting rap on my back and I'm black and snatching crowns. I done came back around like a nigga selling crack and pounds. I got a bag now, but it's nothing to brag about.
Hello everybody and welcome to the Nerdy News, a weekly series releasing every Sunday, recapping the news out of every franchise. But today, we are not doing that. Why? Because it's the first video of 2023. So today, I'm going to talk about what we can expect from this year. I'll talk about movies, shows, games, everything. So yeah, let's go. Soundwave Superior. Of course, we gotta talk about Transformers first, because it's my favorite thing ever, and we have some pretty big things to talk about. Of course, the 7th installment of the live-action Transformers franchise is finally coming. Rise of the Beast is coming on June 9th, 2023, just 6 months away, and like everybody's excited, everybody loves the trailer, including me, and we are kinda still waiting for the second one to drop, which is expected to drop sometime next month in February. Of course, prior to the movie, we are going to see some massive, and I mean massive news. We have many trailers, TV spots to wait for, studio series reviews, toy reviews, like, we have so many merch that's just waiting to get revealed, and I think they're going to reveal it sometime in April or May. That will be, I think everything is going to be worth the wait. And of course, we have to talk about Transformers Earth Park Season 2, or at least the continuation of the first season. The first 10 episodes dropped in November of 2022, and now we are waiting and we are getting closer and closer to some new episodes. I just dropped a video talking about the new episodes, because we have a new Caesar reel, which has like 4 frames of Earth Park, so if you want to hear more about that, you can click the video in the description, I believe I'll post it there. Right now, we don't have a confirmed release date to when the new episodes of Earth Park release, but I think they're going to drop sometime, maybe in spring of this year. And finally, we have to talk about the newest game, Transformers Reactivate, which also doesn't have a release date, what is happening, but I think it will release sometime in fall of 2023. I am pretty excited about this. I might grab it because I feel like I have to, just because. So yeah, definitely, we'll get it. These were all Transformers stuff, and I know that comparing Transformers to Marvel and Star Wars, like, the stuff releasing is so small, like, it doesn't really matter, but Transformers is such a small franchise compared to those, and we have a new movie, a TV series, a game, that's enough for me. So yeah, now let's move on to the big, big boy, Marvel. I don't think anybody is surprised that Marvel, out of every franchise listed here, has the most amount of stuff, and it's been like that since 2021. The quantity is much more than the quality, but let's read what they have for 2023, and we're going on chronological order because they do have release dates for most of the stuff. First off, we have Ant-Man and the Wasp Quantumania, releasing on theaters on the 17th of February, which is like, what, a month away? Let's get the hype train going! The movie looks pretty good, but I don't think it will be the best MCU has put out this year. Kang is the main villain. It's really cool, but in a way also really confusing, because he is the main villain of Quantumania, but then we have like Secret Wars, where he's also expected to be the main villain, and like, what is happening with Kang? Where is he going to be? Is he going to be a villain of multiple projects? I have no idea what will happen, so that's very interesting. Then we have What If Season 2. I'm also kind of interested in this, but also not really. The first season was pretty good, I guess, but it's really forgettable, and Season 2, like, What If is such a strange thing. We don't have a confirmed 100% release date, but I think since it's an animated movie series, fuck, it's going to release maybe in the summer or late spring, I don't know. Then we have another series, which is my most anticipated Marvel series of this year, Secret Invasion, which is releasing spring of 2023. I'm really hyped for this. They're going to have many cameos and many secrets revealed, so it's going to be a fun ride. Nick Fury, of course, as the lead. It's really exciting. Then we have another movie releasing on the 5th of May. We have Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3. And I do believe that this movie will be the best thing Marvel has put out in 2023, because it's the last movie of Guardians of the Galaxy, at least this version of it. And I think it's going to be very emotional, with many depths and many depths of characters. You see what I did there? Like a shitty pun. Then we have another series with a currently unknown release date, just summer 2023, and this is Loki Season 2. The first one at times was very good, at times was very bad, but it did make the fans ask many questions, and I don't think we'll get answers in this one. Then on the 2nd of June, just days before my most anticipated movie, Rise of the Beast, we have my close second, which is Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse. This movie, I'm really hyped about it. In a way, I think Into the Spider-Verse should have been a standalone project, but now they have a sequel plan and then a sequel of the sequel. I don't know, we'll see where the story goes. I think Into the Spider-Verse was probably the best animated movie I've ever seen. And this sequel, I don't think it will top the first one, not gonna lie. Then after a top Spider-Man movie, we have a bottom Captain Marvel movie on July 28th. Of course, I'm talking about The Marvels, a very sequel. I don't know how to describe it. I have no idea. Everybody basically hated Captain Marvel, and now they're bringing like two copies of her. So I don't think it will be a great movie or a good movie. I think it's going to be just mid. And I think it will be at least interesting in a way. If not, well, fuck. Then after that, we have another mid movie, Kraven the Hunter, releasing on the 6th of October. I forgot about this movie entirely, but I think it will be the 2023 version of Morbius. And I'm kind of sad it releases that late into the year, because Morbius, of course, released in April, so we had a lot of time to make memes about it. I feel like Kraven the Hunter, a lot of the memes will shift to 2024 because of its release date. I have no expectations for this movie. I might not watch it just like I did with Morbius. Yeah, that's it. And then let's talk about some series now. These are not 100% confirmed if they will be in 2023. Who knows, maybe Marvel can shift them a bit and put them in 2024. I have no idea. But we have Ironheart, X-Men 97, Echo, and Agatha House of Harkness. Wait, no, Agatha Coven of Chaos. They changed the name here. All of these, I have no idea what I'm probably going to watch them, because I don't know, it's kind of my job as an MCU fan. I feel like I need to watch and do everything. All of these sound mid as fuck, but I guess we'll see what happens when they release. And of course, I just need to talk about Spider-Man 2, of course, the game for PlayStation, also releasing in fall of 2023. I have not played Miles Morales. I have not played Miles Morales. But I have played the first one. It's gorgeous. That game, probably the best game I've ever played on a PS4. Not gonna lie. So yeah, these were all Marvel stuff. Holy shit, they have not learned from their past mistakes, because the quantity here, damn. Now let's move on to Star Wars. Star Wars, not gonna lie, also has quite a bit of stuff, but it's not as bad as Marvel. I'm kinda late with this video because Star Wars actually just dropped something in 2023. Of course, I'm talking about The Bad Batch Season 2, which the first two episodes, I believe, dropped on the 4th of January. I still haven't watched them. I still haven't watched the first season of The Bad Batch, so I don't have really anything to say in this. I thought they were pretty cool in the last season of the Clone Wars, but I don't think they Like, I don't think they work in a standalone project. I think they are good side characters, but I don't think they work in their own separate thing. But I have no idea because I haven't watched it yet. Then on the 1st of March we have The Mandalorian Season 3, Din Djarin and Grogu return yet again. I am hyped for this, but also not really, because what they did with Din Djarin and Grogu in the Book of Boba Fett, I don't think they should have reunited that soon. And I would have been really happy if Grogu could have stayed with Luke to train just a tiny bit more, so that he like grows a bit, knows the basics, gets a lightsaber, you know what I mean? Then all of the rest of the shows and things don't have a release date, which sucks, but let's see. Star Wars Young Jedi Adventures is going to be like a cute little animated series for young kids, which is also kind of weird because, like, you know what happened to the young Jedi? They all got killed by Anakin, so it's going to be interesting where this series takes place. Will it be connected to the Star Wars timeline? I really don't think so. I think it's going to be a separate little thing that doesn't interfere with the main events or something like that. But I will check out like the first 5 minutes of the first episode or something. Then we have Star Wars Visions Season 2, Volume 2. I don't know what they'll call it. It says here Volume 2. I have no idea. Haven't watched the first one. Should I? I don't know. That's it. Ahsoka, Summer 2023. Ahsoka is my most anticipated series, and I'm really hyped to see what they do here to wrap up the storyline that began with Star Wars Rebels. I'm really hyped to see what happens in this. There were so many leaks talking about Hayden Christensen returning yet again as Anakin Skywalker. It's going to be interesting to see what they do in this. Then we have Skeleton Crew, another series. Not really hyped about it, not gonna lie. Releasing in late 2023. I think this is going to be another Andor for me, where I watch like the first three episodes and then give up on the entire thing. I'm sorry, but I personally watch Star Wars only for the Jedi and Sith, not for Andor, like, bro. Oh wait, did I miss something because I'm fucking dumb? Yes, I did. Of course, I'm talking about Star Wars Jedi Survivor, the brand new game that is releasing this year on the 17th of March. I am pretty hyped about this, but also not really because I haven't played the first one. Ooh, shit, Jedi Fallen Order. I still need to try that, but it looks like Jedi Survivor won't come out on the PS4, which sucks. So, fuck you, Cal Kestis. Now let's move on to the next segment. I still don't know what is going to be. DC, DC, DC. Oh god. I have no idea what is happening with DC. I think those guys are really confused right now. They're rebooting a bunch of stuff, they're canceling a bunch of stuff. Like, looking here, we have four films, and I'm pretty sure most of these are going to be canceled, if not all of them. But we'll see what happens. Shazam, Fury of the Gods, releasing on the 17th of March. This is going to be a fun movie. I really enjoyed the first one. It was a blast. So it's going to be interesting what they do in this one. Are they going to tie up some things to Black Adam? I think not, because Black Adam isn't returning ever again. So I have no idea. Then we have the Flash movie. Fuck you, Ezra Miller, Bridger. I don't know. Fuck you. released on the 23rd of June. Of course, Ezra Miller, he is, I don't know really, I'm getting really confused. Are they going to release this shitty movie? Like, we have what, 4 Batmans in this? 18 Flashman? I have no idea. Shit, I'm getting a headache. Why the hell would you release a movie where the main protagonist is a criminal, mentally ill person? Bro, put him in an institution or something. Like, then we have a project which I'm actually excited about, Blue Beetle, releasing on the 18th of August. Blue Beetle is kind of my favorite DC hero. I've been watching him. Like, there was a Batman series, Batman Brave and Beyond. What was that? I don't remember the name, but I do believe Blue Beetle was in this, and he was fucking hilarious. He was the best character in the whole series, and that's why I'm kind of excited for this movie. And then we have the sequel to Aquaman and the Lost Kingdom, releasing on the 25th of December, Christmas 2023. Not really interested in this. I think it's going to be cancelled. We'll see what happens. So yeah, this is all of DC. Really, really stuff. I don't know, fuck you. Dragon Ball. Bro, I'm sorry if I sound a little bit tired, but I am. Dragon Ball, the only good thing on the list. Of course, we just started the new manga saga with Goten and Trunks, where their roles are kind of reversed in a fucking strange way. I have no idea what they were thinking with that. Trunks, who grew up around technology, does not understand computers. Like, how do you mess this up so badly? I have no idea. Like, only the first chapter has been released. I enjoyed it. It was pretty cool. It's really setting up the movie Dragon Ball Super Superhero. There's a prequel, of course. And I think this is going to be a pretty short saga. And then we move on into the bigger saga, which is going to be probably a fight between Black Frieza. That would be pretty cool if that's the case. Like, imagine Goten and Trunks combined in the Gotenks, and then Goku with Ultra Instinct, Vegeta with Ultra Ego, Broly with whatever the fuck he's doing, and everybody teams up against Black Frieza. I heard some theories that Black Frieza might get another form, which is crazy. Like, bro, Black Frieza already defeated Goku and Vegeta with one punch, so if he indeed gets a new form, imagine how strong that would be. But I guess for now we are stuck in the street level crime with Goten and Trunks waiting for the next chapter. Now, I'm really interested to see how they wrap this saga and then the new Black Frieza saga, because they have you feel me, like they need to end in the way that Dragon Ball Z ended, because Dragon Ball Super, of course, takes place in the 10-year time skip between the end of the Majin Buu saga and then the Dragon Ball End of Z saga, which is like two episodes. They really need to fit everything perfectly, so it's going to be interesting how they do that. But, of course, we are still waiting for the anime to return. Like, for the past, like, 2 months, they are teasing it here and there, many leaks, many rumors, and then we have nothing. Of course, we are still waiting for the Moro saga to be made into an anime, and that shit still hasn't happened. I give you a timer until April to release a teaser. I don't care. Are they even working on that? I hope so. I hope so. I want to see it. So yeah. These were all things we should expect from 2023. Of course, you know, like, a bunch of these companies are shady. They're going to reveal something like the next day. I have no idea. Transformers, perhaps, like, Earthspark was revealed in February and then it came out in November. So who knows? Maybe next month they're going to announce like 53 new movies. I hope so. So yeah, this is it. Goodbye, everyone. Take care. 2023 will be better than 2022, at least I hope. We're like a week in and shit feels like the same, but don't worry, I think we'll be better. So yeah, goodbye everyone, take care.